Saudara, penanganan pandemi dan distribusi vaksin untuk negara di Asia Tenggara menjadi sorotan Wakil Menteri Luar Negeri Amerika Serikat Wendy Sherman saat berkunjung ke Jakarta kemarin. Dan berikut wawancara jurnalis Kompas TV Nitya Anissa bersama dengan Wendy Sherman.
4 tahun menjabat sebagai Wakil Menteri Luar Negeri untuk urusan politik, kali ini Wendy Sherman ditunjuk kembali oleh Presiden Biden setelah sebelumnya dipercaya oleh Presiden Barack Obama. Kali ini menjadi Wakil Menteri Luar Negeri untuk Amerika Serikat. Right now, I'm already with Wendy Sherman, Deputy Secretary of State. Thank you for making time for this interview.
I know you have a
very packed schedule for this trip, because obviously you've been to Jakarta, but I think this trip, it's the first trip to Southeast Asia by a senior U.S. official since the Biden administration took office in January. Am I right?
You are right, and in fact, it is my first trip abroad. And to make sure that first trip was to Southeast Asia, to Indonesia, to ASEAN in the first instance, we have an incredibly strong and important strategic partnership with Indonesia. We work on so many things together, from the COVID pandemic to climate, to counterterrorism, to international issues, obviously, what to do about Myanmar since people are suffering so terribly since the coup, and doing everything we can and trying to keep our masks up.
Sure. We're talking about the masks. I think the pandemic, it's still the biggest issue here. Obviously, the United States has taken important steps to support the global vaccinations, but if I may say, many countries in developing countries, including Indonesia, we kind of expect more effort from the states.
Well, I think you're seeing an enormous effort from the United States because of our financial support for COVAX. We are the largest, single largest donor by far to COVAX. That has meant 6 million doses to Indonesia through U.S. support.
Will this be continued?
This will, I think, be continued. You've heard President Biden say that by the end of June, we will donate 80 million doses of vaccine. We are upping, not to Indonesia, but to the world. The president also has a commitment to increase manufacturing. We heard today that many of the drug manufacturers are increasing their production. So I would expect there will be many more doses.
For earlier stages of the pandemic, we've heard of this me first policy that's been clinging to the United States, the European Union, seeing that this Beijing has, rolling out of the vaccines to global vaccinations, delivering to developing countries. How the states, how do you see this, can I say, Chinese vaccine diplomacy?
Well, I think the United States believes that we shouldn't dole out doses for political favors or political leverage.
That's interesting.
We should dole out vaccines because the scientists say, here's where the greatest need is, and then here's the next greatest need, and here's the next greatest need. And to really make sure that we address every country, whatever their relationship with the United States, we want to make sure that we help to end this pandemic and lead that effort.
Like me first policies anymore. I mean, like...
Well, it wasn't a me first. It was sort of, we want to make sure that our country is strong enough to go out and help the rest of the world. We gave a $2 billion to COVAX with a pledge of another $2 billion by 2022. And now we are actually sharing doses, and those announcements will be coming soon.
Your position shows a very promising sign that the foreign policy and under Biden's administration will show, emphasize more in a multilateral approach, but particular for Southeast Asia. Will we be seeing a higher level priority engagement? Is it safe to say that?
Oh, I think it's very safe to say that President Biden, Secretary Blinken have both talked about the importance of multilateral institutions and regional institutions. It is why I am here on this first trip as Deputy Secretary of State. We not only have a strategic partnership with Indonesia, but with ASEAN, of course. Indonesia is host to ASEAN.
You were seeing
I met with all of the ambassadors today, all 10, in a terrific meeting. Very grateful for ASEAN's 5-point plan with Indonesian leadership to move forward. I think the whole world was shocked that after a free and fair election that would have moved Myanmar's democracy another step forward, the military undertook a coup, and we now have a junta running Myanmar. Mm-hmm. And people are in the streets and have been in the streets for weeks because it's not the Myanmar they want. And so we are very appreciative that ASEAN took such a firm and clear position. And we know that with Brunei as chair, there is follow-up coming shortly, envoys that will be named, and hopefully we will get to a better place in the very near future. Our greatest concern is for the human rights of the people in ASEAN. There have many people have been arbitrarily detained, if not killed. We have a very serious situation. We don't want the people of Myanmar to be hurt further. We want to provide humanitarian assistance to them, but we want this change to take place and to return to the democracy that the people of Myanmar want.
Talking about the humanitarian issues, how does the state see the ongoing escalation in Palestine? Seeing you here, for someone who made a deal with Iran, it's a nuclear agreement, everybody's talked about that. What to be expected from here?
Well, I think we saw what's to be expected. President Biden, Secretary Blinken believe firmly in a two-state solution. When Secretary Blinken was recently in the region, he said that both Palestinians and Israelis must have an equal opportunity for peace, stability, prosperity, and a state. We, of course, support Israel, and we defend their right to defend themselves. But we have also said that it is very important to support the Palestinians. So we will be providing humanitarian assistance, reconstruction assistance. We're going to open a consulate again for the Palestinians. Secretary, it's very important that we help the Palestinian people. The United States does consider Hamas a terrorist organization. Mm-hmm. But we do not consider the Palestinian people to be other than people who want a decent life and a future for their children. And so we want to do everything we can to help both the Palestinians and the Israelis have a safe and peaceful future.
Such a strong word. Thank you, Madam Chairman, to make time for us to take this interview. Itu dia wawancara kami dengan Deputy Secretary of State, Wendy Sherman, untuk Kompas TV. Saya Nitya Anissa, terima kasih. Sampai jumpa.